The Tata Altroz is the newest entrant to this premium hatchback space in India. Despite the ongoing crisis due to the COVID-19 pandemic, this car has shown a strong sales performance. In fact, it's among the top three selling cars in this particular segment. That said, the Maruti Suzuki Baleno still tops the sales chart, followed by the Hyundai i20. Then, there's this Tata's new kid on the block, which still continues to pull off decent numbers for the manufacturer. So let's now take a look at the top 5 reasons why owners appreciated and bought this car for. And then, 2 reasons that might have made them rethink a bit. The Altroz looks good, and there are no two ways about it. It's a beautifully designed car. People still give it a second look and with a smile on their face. Now that's quite a compliment for Tata Motors. I remember the time when its official design sketches were revealed as the 45X. It looked so good on paper back then. Besides, it premiered last year at the 89th Geneva International Motor Show. It went on to be Tata's much talked about unveil then. Now, cut to its production version, which looks even better in presence. It's based on the brand's Impact 2.0 design language that primarily strived at improving overall design and styling of cars. I would say it has worked very well in the case of the Altroz. Look at the car from any angle. It just looks stunning. Take for example the front end. The grille is slim, flanked by sleek headlamps which house projector headlights. This, along with a chunky bumper, gives it a nice layered yet proportionate look. There's a tri-arrow shaped fog lamp assembly which also houses the bright white LED DRLs. Then, the sculpted bonnet adds to the muscular front. The aggressive body creases continue all over the body to give it a chiseled look. Take for example the side profile of this hatchback. It gets this strong belt line that runs across its length to merge into the tail lamps. The alloy wheel pattern also looks quite striking. Now, round at the back, the car has a short overhang and an interesting design like its sibling, the Harrier. Besides, the LED tail lights are designed in such a way that along with the floating roofline, the Altroz sports a very unique look. Now, take a look at this, rather, try to hear this. This speaks volume for itself. Then, this thick sheet metal, robust underpinnings hint at this being a solidly built car, which it indeed is. Despite being a big car, the Altroz is light, weighing just about a ton. It has been engineered on the Alpha, Agile Light Flexible Advanced Architecture. This platform lets it inherit these weight-saving measures along with modular and flexible characteristics. In fact, it's the only car in its segment to have scored a 5-star safety rating in the global NCAP test. This is another major attribute that is making buyers get the Altroz. Now, you can directly step into its cabin without having to crouch or anything. This is thanks to a large access and wide opening doors. You are welcomed into a roomy interior with good quality of materials overall. All-round visibility is good with a comfortable driving position as well. Despite being a wide car, all controls are easy within reach and with many storage and stowage places. The second row also offers good room for two and has even sufficient space to fit in one more person. There's good knee room, shoulder room and head room to please a person of my size. This also brings us to the equipment in this car. And it's got many practical features. In fact, they are quite large in number to bring it on par with its competition. These are a comprehensive range of features in this top-of-the-line XZ optional diesel, starting with keyless entry, engine push-start button, height adjustable driver's seat, automatic climate control, rear AC vents, steering mounted controls with telephony, a digital instrument cluster, cruise control, and so on. There's even a large floating touchscreen infotainment system that supports Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. It comes paired with a Harman 6 speaker setup that sounds good. Even on the safety front, it packs in dual front airbags, ABS with EBD, a rear view camera with parking sensors, ISOFIX child seat mounts, speed warnings, and many more features. And as mentioned earlier, apart from the strong 5-star safety rating for adult, it also received a 3-star rating for child occupant protection. This is the only India-made hatchback to have received such high safety rating. There's no sport mode, but this diesel Altroz manages to provide a spirited drive and an impressive performance. This is all thanks to its peppy engine. It's a 1.5-liter turbocharged diesel mill producing 89 bhp of power and 200 Nm of torque. The motor comes alive post 1500 rpm as the turbo spools up and then feels quite energetic at around 2000 rpm. Even before that, it doesn't really struggle to get going and responds to throttle inputs well. It gets quite audible as the tachometer needle heads to point towards 4000 rpm while the car makes quick progress. Still, the mid-range is quite sufficient enough for getting going in traffic and even making a quick overtake. The clutch is light and impressive, given most diesels get a heavy clutch. However, this one's got a shorter travel, is light on the foot, and you don't have to worry much about driving it in traffic for too long. There's no ergonomic issue here. You don't have to stretch your leg, and there's even a dead pedal. You anyway won't have to keep shifting gears often, as this stocky motor makes it easy to keep up with the pace. There's never a dull moment actually. It's very likeable, as there's enough power in this diesel avatar, and you will like it for its handling as well. This electronic power steering is nicely tuned and feels better than the hydraulic ones we've come to see from Tata. It feels light and quick while parking or even making a U-turn. All the same, it weighs up well with increase in speed and the car also shows excellent road stability. Be it a quick turn in or going flat out on the highway, it always feels planted and is confidence inspiring even at triple digit speeds. Some people still ask me, why a diesel in the first place? And my instant response to them is the answer to the same cliche question that many people ask. Kitna deti hai? And I kid you not, Tata Motors claims a fuel efficiency of 25.11 km to a litre for this. Yes, that's a mind-boggling number, but certainly not unbelievable. The instrument cluster showed up 15-16 km per litre figure, and that too in city traffic. This is also when I remember I didn't have a chance to put it in the 4th or 5th gear. And when the car actually got a chance over an open wide road, the fuel economy figure shot up towards 19 km per litre. Now, that's quite a promising number and owners are going to love it for being so frugal. Let's give it up for Tata Motors, especially for having Indian engineers work on these Indian cars for our Indian road conditions and for us Indian buyers. There's something about this. I just love the way it deals with our road conditions. And you will love it too, for it will remain rock steady on whatever conditions our roads throw at it. At 165 mm, its ground clearance isn't the best in segment, but good enough to not bottom out anywhere given its compact footprint. Good fuel efficiency and a sorted ride means more relaxed time on the road with less visits to the fuel pump. Needless to say, taking it out on a long trip will not require a second thought with such an excellent ride comfort and mile munching capability. When you step up to the premium segment of cars, buyers want to have some luxury that convenience that an automatic transmission brings in, and not having an automatic variant is like a missed opportunity. The availability of this trim would not only have meant wide range of options for buyers to choose from, but also meant to tap in the customers from another segment. In today's day and age, and especially with the increasing traffic day by day, an automatic gearbox reduces the effort of shifting gears and pressing the clutch. It makes it a very hassle-free process for drivers spending hours in traffic. A diesel automatic would have just done wonders. They say good things come at a price is either a perception or a reality. Well, in this case for this diesel, it is the latter. Tata Motors has priced the entry-level XC Petrol at Rs. 5.44 lakh ex-showroom. However, this particular top-spec diesel is priced at Rs. 9.09 lakh ex-showroom. That brings it to Rs. 10.83 lakh or almost Rs. 11 lakh on-road price in Mumbai. That's quite a high premium buyers will have to shell out. Sure, there's no other diesel at this moment for prospective buyers, but a more considerate pricing surely would have helped Tata rake in more numbers. Now we've taken a look at both its positives and negatives. However, the Altroz has one big benefit currently, which is it being a diesel. None of its competitors have this option for now. Yes, be it the Maruti Suzuki Baleno, Hyundai i20, Toyota Glanza, or even the Honda Jazz, none are presently available with a diesel motor. That's one more reason that will easily help the car maker pull some sales numbers for this car. And for you, who must have already figured out by now, still do take a spin in the Tata Altroz to ascertain these aforementioned things for yourself. Do let us know your feedback in the comment section below. Like, share and subscribe to Carwale's YouTube channel.